All right, I've got my clay set up, and I lowered it down onto a small sculpting stand. Pardon the floor, it's as clean as I can get it. Anyway, I've got this on a Lazy Susan. This is a homemade turntable. And what I did was I used a Lazy Susan, which I'm showing you here. That's the Lazy Susan. And what I did was attached it to a board, and then I attached it to the other board. And you drill a hole in the board to match up with the hole in the Lazy Susan. And when you turn Lazy Susan, you can, therefore, from the other side, screw this side, or this surface, down to another board. And so you got a Lazy Susan that you can turn, and it makes a nice little portable sculpting stand. So that brings it down to where my eyes are just above the head, so I'm looking down at the piece, and so now I can work on the face and shoulders and the arms and all that stuff a lot easier than standing up and trying to do with my old back. You know, I got almost 70 years on my old back. I'm just about done for here. Anyway, just wanted to show you the setup before I get started. Easier to work on it from this level than to try and work on it from any other level. Anyway, that's just gonna add the clay to the skull, and I think I can do the whole head here attached, which I really would rather do than doing it detached. If you're wondering what these are, I stuck my hand underneath a kind of a splintery board and got some splinters in my fingers, and I don't think I got all the splinters out, but they'll work themselves out eventually. Now let's take a look at this. Alright. If you look at the proportions, if I can find my calipers. Here they are. If you look at the proportions of his face, usually the eyes are about halfway down the face. In this case, the upper part of his head, from his middle of his eyes to the top of his head, comes down to his mouth. So that's why Native American heads are so hard to do, because they're out of proportion. They're very unique people. And so I'm going to first of all put that picture right there. I'm going to raise his head up just a little bit. And gotta figure out how I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna take down this chin just a little bit. Nice thing about Truform, you can carve on it a little bit if you have to. I see no need to do that with the cheekbones. That'll be fine. I'll actually work around that. I know where I want the head, so I'm going to, just a temporary fix. Push this clay in here and on the back of his head, and that will keep the head from moving, hopefully. In other words, yes, it's a ready-made armature, but that doesn't mean you can't think. It doesn't take away the thought process, and it doesn't take away your creativity and your ability to see and translate through your fingers. You still have to do that. This just takes up room that clay would take and gives you proportions that you don't have to work out. And that's why I like Truform armatures. Do is add some to his chest, or bottom chin. Got a very broad chin. Boy, he must have been some figure. Looks like it's fairly wide, just below the bridge of his nose. Which might indicate that his nose is a little bit crooked. the other camera, the battery just quit and has no juice, and I just need to get it recharged, which is going to take an hour or more, and it's just too late in the evening to be doing that, so I'll pick this up tomorrow. It's a good place to stop. I'm starting to get bothered by this thing, and I don't know what it is that's bothering me, so I'll have to come back tomorrow and take a look at it and let it tell me what I'm doing wrong. So that's what I'm going to do. I'll see you guys tomorrow.